I'll do whatever say I do.
A little bit louder.
Hey, what's going on, guys? It's me, Dave from FunderHunt. A lot of you guys know me as Davron Karimov from back in the day. I want to make this video because I know you guys have been seeing a lot of Josh recently, a lot of Joshua Gasparados. But really, what I want to talk to you guys today about is he's on a meeting right now. So what I want to talk to you guys today about is about business owners. I had a business owner today. One of them, he sent me a COJ, a notarized COJ. What is a COJ? It is a confession of judgment. Let me write that out for you. It's spelled COJ. So what is a COJ? A COJ stands for a confession of judgment. This basically ensures to the lenders that whoever you're working with, they can basically say, you know, I am guilty of taking this money and putting the capital to use and paying back this money. So let look at here. So the guy signs a COJ. He gets it notarized. Boom, boom. Fantastic. But here's what he did wrong. He took a picture of the COJ. It's like me taking a picture of myself. It's like me taking a selfie as my business. That's not how you take a business document. You gotta make a scan. So where this business owner messed up was instead of making a scan of the COJ, he ended up taking a picture from a cell phone. And typically that's fine. You know, if it were me lending the money, I wouldn't care. You got me a picture, it's all good. You got it done. But since we're doing this out house, we're gonna need a scan. So that's how you avoid this problem. If you're a business owner, you gotta make sure that you take a scan, you gotta get a scan copy. Not even for my records. You gotta get it for your own records. Because if you have a scan copy, you're gonna have a copy for your own records. You know, you follow me? All right, so next thing is, there was a business owner similarly to this situation, to this example, there was another business owner who didn't want to sign a COJ. He refused. This business owner refused to sign the COJ. And I'm like, well, gosh, you've done three business loans before. You've done them before. So what makes you think that if you do another capital injection that you can't sign a COJ? What is the issue? And so the guy tells me, well, if I miss a payment here, if I miss one payment, you guys can put a judgment on me. And look, you're absolutely right. You're absolutely true. There's been a lot of people coming into this industry the last 3 years, you know, high school dropouts, you know, promising you everything. And then when it comes out, they could put a judgment on you without even telling you about it. That's true. But here's the thing. When this is coming from a high-risk underwriting team, it's coming from a high-risk underwriting team, there has to be a COJ. A COJ is a confession of judgment. I'm taking this capital. I'm taking the capital and putting it into work. So what does this mean to you? This means that you gotta be prepared. You gotta be prepared. No matter who you are, no matter if you make $10,000 a month or you make $1 million a month, you gotta be prepared for the COJ. You gotta be prepared for anything. You need to put this capital to use. You are a business owner. You gotta make a decision right now. You gotta make a decision right now. Do you want to expand your business? Yay or nay? You can only decide the answer to the option. But anyway, guys, that's it for today. I want to take the time to thank you so much for all the support you've been giving us, guys. FunderHunt here in our new office. We got a new office. It's at 85 Broad Street. Come visit us. I just want to say thank you guys so much. And make sure you guys leave a like, thumbs up, and put a comment. Let me know what you think about COJs. Is it worth it or is it not worth it? Let me know. Put it in the comments below. I'll talk to you soon. Thanks, guys.